Hi everyone, welcome to this Facebook Live session. My name is Aditya Bhatti and I head the marketing operations for NorthTech, which is a New Zealand government owned institute. And I'm doing this session in partnership with the Turning Point, which is one of the good agents that we have in North India. And any students aspiring to know more about NorthTech and our programs, they are welcome to contact the Turning Point team. Now, before wasting anybody's any more time, I'm going to give you a little introduction regarding the institute and the programs that we offer, where we are based, what kind of post-study work visas are allowed under current immigration policies of New Zealand, and then if somebody has got any questions, please feel free to ask those questions and I'll be happy to answer the same. You can ask those questions in the chat box and I'll try to address them as much as possible. Like I said in the beginning, we are a government-owned institute of New Zealand. Our main campus is in a city called Whangarei. Whangarei is about 170 kilometers north of Auckland. So basically the region above Auckland is called Northland. And NorthTech is the government institute for that region. By drive in your own car, it takes about 2 hours from Auckland. This is a campus which has got a lot of domestic students and international students studying both of them together. So this is where you get a lot of multicultural experience. Very, very big campus with the park-like grounds. We've got facilities which are purpose-built. So for example, we've got an on-campus cafe and restaurant, which our hospitality and cookery students use, and that's where they get real-life skills. So they're able to use their skills and knowledge they get in their classroom in a real cafe and restaurant. Similarly, we got a beauty salon. We also have an art gallery wherein our students of arts, whether it is painting or sculpture or printmaking, they are able to display the work that they have created. Then we also have an international campus, which is at Auckland, and this is on Queen Street, which is the CBD of Auckland, which means right in the heart of the business district of Auckland. We have an international campus. So when I say international campus, this is a campus on which only international students study. We don't have any domestic students on this campus, so students who seek to study in an off in a campus wherein the focus is international, where the faculty is more used to teaching international students, this is a very good choice for them. So we give you the best of both worlds. We give you the metro city like Auckland, and we also give you the regional experience in Whangarei. Now, as far as the programs are concerned, we offer a huge wide variety of programs that are there. For example, at Whangarei, I'll start with Whangarei and then we'll cover the programs that we offer at Auckland. At Whangarei, we have arts, we've got information technology, we've got business management, we've got engineering, we've got architectural technology, we've got science, we've got sports. So a lot of big areas in terms of choices are there, and we also have nursing. So to give you an idea, program-wise, we'll talk about the cookery one, which is one of the popular ones in India. So we got the level 5 diploma in cookery, which we offer at Whangarei. This program is available to all students who've done class 12 from any stream. Their IELTS requirement is 5.5. And it's a typical 2-year program. And as anyone who's familiar with New Zealand education system is aware that there's a lot of demand for chefs in New Zealand. Our fee structure is one of the most competitively priced fee structures, with the second year fees usually being about $10,400. So basically what you get is you get a lot of support in terms of your fee structure payments and all of that in terms of making it friendly for international students. Then the other program that I want to talk about is the New Zealand Diploma in Environment Management. This is one of the unique programs that we have, and I definitely encourage a lot of students who've done their 10 plus 2 with science, medical, that's physics, chemistry, bio background, or similar environment science background, to look at this program. This program focuses on ecology, conservation, biosecurity, biodiversity, and environment management. There's a lot of focus on these areas in New Zealand, and there are a lot of job opportunities in these areas. and very few education providers, including the government ones, offer a program in this area. So graduate job opportunities are also very, very good. The next available intake for this program will be Feb 2021. The fees is approximately $19,000 for first year. This also leads to a degree called BSc Biodiversity Management. So basically you do a 2-year program. After that, if you want, you can directly enroll in the third year of the degree. Alternatively, you can work for some time under the current immigration policy. There's permission for you to work. And then after working for a year or so, then you can come in directly again into the third year of the degree if you want to complete the degree at that stage. Another unique area that we have is the New Zealand Diploma in Sport, Recreation and Exercise. This again leads to a bachelor's degree in sport and recreation, third year admission. This is a very, very big industry in Northland. In fact, it is the seventh biggest industry in Northland as far as jobs is concerned, with nearly about 2,000 Northlanders working in this sport and recreation industry. This is again available to any class 12 pass out students. You could have studied from any background, but if you've been an active sports player in any sport at your school level, club level, district level, then you are the ideal candidate for such a program. And New Zealand focuses a lot on sports as a career, so there's a lot of scope there, so to speak. Again, we have a Feb intake, typical NZQA IELTS requirements of 6 months with no score less than 5.5. Then tuition fees is about $19,700. Here I want to talk to you about one of our success stories who's from North India. This is Winkle Gore. Winkle Gore's story is, Winkle, I met him when he was roughly about 30 years old. He'd already done his MCOM in India and working as an accountant in India since about 8-9 years. And basically everybody that he met told him that it is not possible for him to get a visa for a sports program because he doesn't have a formal qualification in sports. Luckily, he and I ended up meeting each other at one of the agency's offices. I met him. I found that he's got a very big passion towards sports, and he did have, a lot of certificates to support his interest in sports. And he had been a yoga trainer and a personal coach to many people. And I realized that his passion was genuine. Luckily, we were able to not only get him a visa, he has done amazingly well in the program at NorthTech, and is currently working as a rehabilitation manager in Whangarei itself. Not only that, Winkle has actually found someone there. So he's basically got married about a year back in Whangarei and is on his way to settlement in Whangarei. Then I want to talk about engineering related areas. For again, anybody who's not familiar with New Zealand, there's a lot of demand in New Zealand for civil engineering and related programs. So we've got a New Zealand diploma in civil engineering, and we also have a New Zealand diploma in architectural technology level 6. Again, these are programs available to anybody who's done class 12 with physics, chemistry, maths, or a 10 plus 3 diploma in civil engineering, civil draftsman, or any similar area. 2-year programs, Feb intake, $19,700 is the fees for first year. Again, I want to talk about one of our success stories. We actually have very good success stories in the civil engineering area, to the point that we've got, 100% students who have come in for civil have found jobs in New Zealand and are on their way to getting PR. The ones who came in quite a few years back have already found their way to residency. One story that I want to talk about is Paras Monga, who's currently working with an intermediate projects engineer with the Whangarei District Council at NorthTech at Whangarei itself. So he came in, he's completed our diploma in engineering in 2016. He's always had an interest in highway and traffic engineering. So when he completed a diploma, he specialized in roading. In this last year of his studies, we were able to get him a job with a local civil engineering consultancy firm, which later on led him to his engineering career in New Zealand. We also have many other stories like his. We have got Marinder, who we were able to get him internship in his first year of studies in civil engineering. The internship per se was unpaid, but when he came into the second year of his studies, the place where he was interning, they were so happy with his performance, they actually paid for half of his tuition fee for second year. And after his program completion, they've given him a full-time job, and he's still working with them. He's got his residency. So we have a lot of success stories in this particular area. And for people who don't want to get into the civil engineering aspect, they could obviously consider architectural technology, which again is in a big demand. And again, something that I would recommend strongly for people who are considering, because these are programs that lead to successful career outcomes. I've talked about Kukri already, and now I'm going to talk about some of the programs that are available for our graduates, which means for people who have already done their bachelor degree in India. So one of the qualifications that we have is a graduate diploma in project management. Graduate diploma in project management is actually available to any graduate, but I would particularly want to put focus on people who have done engineering degrees or IT related degrees, because information communication technology project managers and construction project managers are in skill shortage in New Zealand, which means to say there's a huge shortage of skilled manpower in these areas. So people who have done mechanical engineering, civil engineering, electrical engineering, all of these people have chances to find a construction project management job in the civil construction industry. Whereas if you've done an IT degree, electronics telecommunication degree, or computer applications, or any of those areas which are related to ICT industry, so to speak, again, project management is an amazing area for you. We have a FEB intake with approximately 19,700 being the fees. Please note, I'm saying approximate in a lot of cases because the 2021 fees is to be finalized in some cases. Then I want to talk about two other graduate diplomas at Whangarei. One is a graduate diploma in business. This is for a generic introduction to what business management is all about, and is again available to graduates from any industry. So let's assume you have somebody who's done BA in India, which is not really a professional qualification, and they want to do a 1 year qualification, which will give them some potential to find a job in any country, especially New Zealand. Then a graduate diploma in business is a very good option for such students, because it gives them a qualification which allows them to seek entry-level jobs in various management areas, be it customer care or office administration or marketing or HRM. So that's a very, very good area for somebody who hasn't really had any background at all. But the fact is, it is available to all graduates. So people who've done BBA, BMS, all of those areas, this is a very good program for them. Then we have the graduate diploma in business information systems. This is actually one of our top-selling programs. This program is a combination of management and IT, which means it makes you a business analyst or an ICT analyst. Basically, what it does is it teaches you how to use information technology to manage businesses better. This program has got a lot of career prospects again, because these system analysts and business analysts and ICT analysts are again in skill shortage in New Zealand. So chances of finding a job in these areas are good. Again, typical requirements are laid down by NZQA for IELTS, which is 6 bands with no score less than 5.5. Fees is approximately $19,500. This is crux of the main programs that are available and are the, how should I say, top-selling programs in India market. But we also have other programs like we have the Bachelor of Nursing. We also have the Bachelor of Arts with a specialization in digital arts as well as visual arts. So these are areas that if you've got people who are interested in applied arts, they could look up our website or contact us through Turning Point for more information on these areas. Talking about Auckland, like I said, this is a city campus. It's a central business district campus. So in here, what you will find is a full-fledged campus for students to get all the information and education that they require. It's Wi-Fi, it's got an international focus, it's got a recreation room for the students, and it's located right in the heart of the business district of Auckland. Here, the program that I want to talk about and put focus on is the bachelor degree in applied information systems. So this is particularly for people who have done class 12 or a 10 plus 3 diploma in IT, people who want to pursue IT as a career. This is a program which is a holistic IT career focused degree program and gives you an holistic information and knowledge about what IT is all about. This qualification is actually listed on Immigration New Zealand's long-term skill shortage list. The fee of this program is amazingly competitive, with approximately 18,000 being first year fees and second year being 12,800 or so, and third year being about 9,500, which means that second year and third year with scholarship, your fees does get very, very competitive. In my knowledge and experience, I believe this is one of the most competitively priced Bachelor of Applied Information Systems program available in New Zealand among the government institute setups. So for anybody who's seeking to study IT at a business degree level, please look into this program. And if you have any questions, I would welcome you to bring those questions to us and we'll be happy to answer them. The second degree program that I want to talk about is the Bachelor of Applied Management program. In the Bachelor of Applied Management program, there are two areas. One is one without a specialization. So this is like a BBA in India, a general BBA. And the other is the Bachelor of Applied Management with a specialization in Business Information Systems. Here again, this is similar to the Graduate Diploma in Business Information Systems that we talked about. So what it does, it again leads you to a career which is on the skill shortage list, the ICT analysts and the system analysts. The normal entry requirement from an English perspective for these programs is 6 bands with no score less than 5.5. But in the Bachelor of Applied Management area, students with 5.5 overall and no score less than 5 can also enter this program choosing the New Zealand Diploma Business Level 5 pathway, which means they can enter into the program with a Level 5 New Zealand diploma. And then in the second year, they could enroll into the degree if they meet the IELTS requirements. We've got 5 intakes for this program at Auckland. We've got Jan, March, June, August, and October. Again, the fee is very, very competitive. We offer $3,000 scholarship in this program, making it roughly about $17,000 for first year, and second year and third year are at $15,000 each. We've got a very good story of Anand, who's completed his Bachelor's of Applied Management as an RPL's graduate. He had completed his master's from UK and the bachelor's from India, and then he had some work experience from India and UK as well, but UK was not meeting his requirements, so he came back to India and connected with me. He was considering about different colleges and programs and cities. Luckily, he took my advice and he came in to find NorthTech, and after completing the program, he was able to get job with ASB Bank, wherein he was already working with them as a part-time employee while he was studying. And he graduated in 2017. By October 2018, he had already got his residency and he's bought a house in Auckland. So he's doing again amazingly well for himself in the country. Then we've got the New Zealand Diploma in Quantity Surveying. New Zealand Diploma in Quantity Surveying is again one of those construction related areas. So here I want to focus a little on the construction quantity surveying job description before I go further. So quantity surveyor is a finance manager, or the one who controls or manages the finances of a construction project. So they've got 3 roles basically. One is cost estimation, quantity quality estimation, and second is vendor management, which means they manage the vendors from where the raw material is procured. And the third is the financial management or contract management, so to speak, because whichever vendors you finalize, there is a contract with them. So contract management, vendor management, and finance management, these are 3 management roles of a quantity surveyor. So if there are class 12 graduates who are looking for a management related area, but an area in which they are likely to find a job easily, rather than doing a generic management program, they will do a very, very smart thing if they chose a program like the New Zealand Diploma in Quantity Surveying. So this is a program that again I would recommend very, very intensively to anybody who's looking to come into New Zealand with an aim to get some return on investment and find a career opportunity there. Again, we've got 5 intakes. This is available to any class 12 pass out or a 10 plus C diploma in civil similar. The first year fee is about 17,700 and second year is approximately 11,000. So again, there's a reasonable drastic drop down in second year fees, making it one of the most competitively priced programs as far as quantity surveying is concerned. Here I want to share the story of Kanishth Vashisht. I met Kanishth in 2016. And the story was that he had joined BTech Civil in one of the Indian universities in 2012. And in 2016, his parents realized that he had actually been failing or getting compartments in his degree programs throughout. And so it was not likely that he could get out of the degree and pass it. He tried for a little more, but it didn't work. So everywhere he went, he was basically told that he is not likely to get into a country like New Zealand. He should be trying places like Singapore or Dubai. Luckily, we ended up meeting each other. I found that there's a spark in him. I realized that he had probably, you know, kind of lost track when he was doing his degree. But basically, he's a smart boy. He's hardworking. He just needs the right kind of guidance. Luckily, he was willing to learn, adapt, and mend his ways. We worked together. He was able to get his visa, and after completing the program, which he actually completed in A grades throughout, he's now currently working as an assistant quantity surveyor with the quantity surveying company in Auckland. So this is an again a story of typically what people would generally say, that it is not possible for students with such backgrounds to get visas. So Namdeep, this basically addresses your question, but I'll address it a little more detail once I'm done with talking about the questions. We also offer the Graduate Diploma in Business and the Graduate Diploma in Business Information Systems at Auckland. I will not explain much about the programs per se, because I've already explained the programs in my earlier talk when I was talking about Whangarei. So this is basically a coverage of what all programs that we offer at NorthTech. Coming to your question, Navneet, regarding what is the maximum gap year acceptable, there is no one size fits all answer, Navneet. The fact is, as far as New Zealand is concerned, each application is assessed on its own merits and demerits. And so far, there is a rational, logical, valid, and supported by documentary evidence explanation regarding a gap. People who are 40 plus have got visas as far as New Zealand is concerned. So it depends on what you were doing in the gap, what is the explanation for it, and what is the documentary evidence you have support to, you know, basically show what you were doing in this gap. If that's taken care of and you're choosing the right program and right provider, like I said, people who are 40 plus, they have managed to get their student visa approval. So that's really not a big deal. This is the end of my talk as far as I am concerned. If somebody has got any questions, anything to ask, please feel free to ask. So for anyone who has joined, we basically covered the programs that we offer at NorthTech. So I'm quickly going to do a little talk about it because I don't think there's anybody who's got any questions. I'm just going to quickly go over the basics of what NorthTech is all about. We are a government institute of New Zealand. We've got two campuses. The main campus is at Whangarei. Whangarei is about 2 hours from Auckland. This is a multicultural campus with a lot of domestic students and international students studying together on the same campus in same classes. We also have an international campus at Auckland, which is basically, as you can understand, has an international focus. So there are no domestic students here. This campus is in the Central Business District of Auckland, which is on the Queen Street. We offer approximately 100 programs with a wide range of areas from business, cookery, IT, applied arts, sports, science. So depending on a student's area, whether you are an undergrad or you have already completed your bachelor degree, which program area are you interested in, you could look at the different program options that we have. We've got the options and opportunities for both kind of students, undergraduate levels and bachelor degree level students at both the campuses. Not all programs are available at both the campuses. So some programs are only available at Whangarei and some programs are only available at Auckland. In the Auckland campus, we usually have 5 intakes a year, whereas at Whangarei, usually there are 2 intakes a year, which are Feb and July. Sometimes for some of the programs, we could have a summer intake, which will be usually in around October, November. But that's something that's never a confirmed thing till we reach usually about, say, June, July of that year. That's the time we usually take a call on whether we're going to have a summer intake. So that's really as far as the intakes is concerned. Most of the programs have the standard IELTS requirements as laid down by New Zealand Qualification Authority, which is 6 bands with no score less than 5.5 if the program is at level 6 or 7. If the program is at level 5.5, then it is a 5.5 overall requirement with no score less than 5. The fees of the programs are very competitive. In some of the programs like the Bachelor or Degree of Applied Information Systems and the Bachelor Degree in Applied Management, we are very, very competitively priced, and students who have done class 12 are seeking to be in New Zealand for a bachelor's degree, I would definitely recommend that you consider NorthTech as one of your options. Current immigration policies state that if you complete a bachelor's degree in New Zealand, the student would be eligible for a 3 years of postgraduate work permit, making the bachelor's degree a very, very attractive proposition, especially with the fee structure that we offer, ensuring an excellent return on investment. So this is basically an overview of it. Any questions, if anyone has got, please feel free to ask me now. Otherwise, what you can see is reach out to Turning Point at a later stage, and then I'll be happy to answer those questions. Okay, so Navneet, you asked whether PSW is available. I've already answered that. Somebody is asking a question about UK, which obviously I can't answer. Navneet, I've talked about scholarships already. Okay, I've already talked about the scholarships in different program. You say how many international students are there right now. What we do is we take in our average intake from India. On an average would be about, say, 150 students annually. So that would be a rough idea as to how many students are there, because students who are there for 2 year programs are usually there for 2 years. So you would, that's the kind of student strength that you're looking at as far as the strength is concerned. Of course, some students are in Auckland and some of these are in Whangarei. Scholarships I've already covered, so that's taken care of. So I think nobody seems to have any questions. What is the COVID-19? I think everyone is aware the COVID situation was quite under control, and New Zealand managed about 100 days to go COVID free, and then they again got fresh infected cases. It's still controlled and they are trying to go hard on it. So they are still on alert levels, and hopefully we will again see New Zealand being COVID free in a very, very short span of time. It still is considered, I think, the second best country in the world in terms of how they have managed the COVID situation. And I think everybody understands and accepts, and the international students also have acknowledged the level of support that they've got from the government and the institutes in terms of looking after them in terms, whether it is financially or otherwise. So I think the government of New Zealand has done a very good job in managing COVID situation. There is no IELTS waiver if a student can provide MOI. This is a very, very, very old process. When do I believe face-to-face classes will start? It is difficult to say at this stage. We are all hopeful that there will be a pilot, so to speak. There will be a trial to allow some international students into the country for the Feb intake. Having said that, it basically will be seen probably another 4 months down the line, or you know, once probably mid-November we are there, or end of November we will come to know probably whether this pilot is going to include India or not, because it's not just about what the situation is in New Zealand, it is also about what the COVID situation is in India. And as we all know that the situation in India is not really under control at this stage, and that could be a cause of concern in terms of New Zealand allowing international students into the country immediately. We should probably have some kind of clarity by maybe late November, early December. Again, till I think the 10th of November, visa applications cannot be filed. There's a freeze on submission of visa applications till the 10th of November. So for now, the earliest that you can start is 10th of November. But students who are keen, who are serious, who want to go, I would advise them to keep their files ready, applications ready, by first week of November. So the moment it is possible technically and legally to submit your visa applications, you should submit them at the earliest, because Immigration New Zealand is basically likely to follow the process of first in, first out. So the ones that submit them earlier are likely to get their decisions earlier. The ones that submit them later are likely to get their decisions later. Yes, we can issue admission offer letters to eligible students, both conditional as well as unconditional for most programs. depending on the students, of course, eligibility and meeting our admission requirements. So barring programs like nursing, most of the offer letters are issued from the India office. So yes, it is possible to issue offer letters. Thank you so much for all your help and in conducting this event, and I look forward to more inquiries from Turning Point and their students. Have a good evening, everyone. Bye. Take care.